Yeah, man. Yes, indeed. It's going on the King Calvin Jones Jr. Show. It's your boy, King Calvin Jones Jr., a.k.a. King Cal Cutter on the up and up, man. It's going down for sure. You better know what it is, partner. It's still, you know, I still keep it 100% hood for y'all, but it's purified, you know what I'm saying? I ain't like nobody else, partner. You better understand what it is. It's an empire in itself being established. You know, and all glory go to God, Playboy. So anyway, you want to check us out, you know, the King Calvin Jones Jr. Show. If you got a book you've authored, you got some poetry, even if you got the flow, you know, as long as it's presentable, you know what I'm saying? You know, played the harp skillfully and the evil spirit left Saul. You know, Saul had an evil spirit, and all David did, he didn't sing some love song. He didn't do nothing else. All he did for deliverance to take place was play the instrumental. He didn't lay his hands on her. He didn't push nobody. He didn't do nothing, man. And that's what I'm talking about here on the King Calvin Jones Jr. Show. You ain't even got to get hands laid on you and you can get miracles. That's the power of God that people are looking for. In these last and evil days, they don't want all them shenanigans and stuff to take place. They don't want all that to happen. They want that real deal stuff. They want to know, hey, can I get a miracle from God and he not here? Can you get peace when you ain't even being touched by nobody? That's the power of God that he gave us. You ain't even got to be in existence. You can be as far as from north to the south, the east to the west, and God can still give you that miracle. You understand what I'm saying? You ain't gotta be down like these watered down folks that ain't 100 on everything. You know, granted that people have fell short of the glory of God, you know, you still get an opportunity. You ain't hogwashing nothing. You ain't wishy-washy. You ain't sanctimonious. You ain't on that world trumpet stuff, as you heard me say on many times on the CJC Hood News platform. Folks get like that, you know, so I want to definitely give you an opportunity to get connected to the connector, even on this particular platform here. You know, I give everything to God when I'm doing, you know, my show, and I make sure that it's being presentable too, you know, because folks need that instrumental. And not only that, it don't have to be specifically sanctimonious, you know what I'm saying, before you get a miracle. It just got to be soothing to you, something that'll get you out of that stress that you up under. You know what I'm talking about? So that's what we do. You know, we ain't got to speak some big words. And I showed a demonstration. See, sometimes I do find myself doing that, but I'm being myself. You understand? So instrumentals all by itself, which is unheard of, but it's been true. You know, the instrumentals alone can bring healing, man. No matter what you're going through, if you hear that one instrumental, you'll think about something and it you know, cause calmness over you. It cause your continence to change. And that's what I have created the King Calvin Jones Jr. Show, and thing is a rap, but really is not, because folks looked at Enoch, and Enoch, he served God so much that God took him up, you know, to a whole nother realm. You know, it wasn't that a person did anything. It was God himself said, you know, you walk with me like this, I might as well come get you. You know, you done dedicated yourself to me. So we two became one. Since you dedicated yourself to me, I cannot come back for what belongs to me. And that's what God is doing in this season. He is really coming back for his people. So if you dedicated yourself to God, don't be surprised if he was requiring you to, you know, he's asking you of something. You know, be prepared in season and out of season. It might not be like winter, summer, spring, and fall with God, but God's seasons a little different. Man had the power to change time laws and seasons, but God also change seasons. You know, you never know what's going to happen. Today is sunny, tomorrow is raining, or, you know, next week is it be something else. You know what I'm saying? So you want to definitely stay connected, you know, to the move of God. That's what I'm really purposing for you. And it's not a one day thing. This is an everyday thing. This is a 24 hours, 7 days a week, 365 days a week for you. I want you to get there. You know, as I'm pushing there at the same time, I want you to get there on a whole nother level. I'm telling you, it's possible. I touched the hem of God's heart, you know, with, you know, my mind being, you know, my thoughts being cast aside so that I can do what he's purposed me to do. And I wasn't even thinking about really doing this on this particular level today, but I wanted to, you know, because I want to see people get set free. And what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to speak the word of God. We're going to go into the words of the Lord, you know, not in tradition way whatsoever. But I want to encourage somebody today. I want to give somebody some hope that feels hopeless. Let us go before the throne of grace and mercy right now. And let me say a word of prayer for you. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Father, give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and most importantly, God, it gives you glory. Right now, and in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I give praise, honor, and glory right now. Because I know that I have visions of Jesus Christ, our Lord, you know, myself. But I'm alive. You know what I'm saying? Some folks had say they seen God. Man, if you seen God, the creator of the universe, you will perish, you know, because he don't see no flesh. He don't see the things of this world within his people. And what he wants to see in us is himself. I'm getting so amped up right now. I wasn't even supposed to be doing this on this particular segment of the King Calvin Jones Jr. Show. But I want to tell you right now that there are some thoughts that you've thought, but God's thoughts for you are way above your thoughts, your father's thoughts, your mother's thoughts, your brother's thoughts, your sister's thoughts, your uncle's thoughts, your auntie's thoughts, your cousin's thoughts. That's why God told Abraham, get thee out of thy country in Genesis chapter 12, 1, 2, and 3. He told him some instructions. And when he did it, the miracles happened. Signs and wonders followed. And not only he didn't leave them to abandon them for destruction, but he left them to only save them. See, some people, you wouldn't leave, so they went into captivity. But when, if you was to leave and would have followed God, you would have saved everybody that you was connected to. What you say now? I said, you would have saved everybody you was connected to if you would have just connected to God in a righteous manner. Some folks thought they was doing God a favor and trying to stick with the same people that they were with. And then they got taken away from the place that they were in. So I tell you that when you humble yourself under the mighty hand of God, I'm talking about the God of the universe, not the God that was lifted up because people needed somebody that they can physically see and promote as God, that wind up letting them down in some areas, you know, that left them in captivity. He didn't come deliver them. He didn't send nobody to represent him, shape, form, or fashion, the God that other folks claim that they worship. But the God that I know, he come see about you. He come deliver you from your captivity, your snares. Tell, he wouldn't have been above only. He would have just been beneath. He wouldn't have been able to lend, and maybe he would have, but not as much as God wanted him, you know, barely making it. And some folks cool with that. They like, you know what? I don't want nothing more than what I got. I just want to barely make it, but it's stressful. And then the love of the money is the root of all evil, which while some covet after some and pierce themselves with many sorrows. So people, they covet after. You know, see how I put that together like that? If you're not biblically sound in doctrine, you could get toe up from the flow up and thinking that was book, chapter, and verse. But my point was this, that people covet it, go after stuff, and they hurt themselves because they don't have enough of it. They're greedy for stuff that God's not really wanting them to have. See, it's in the scriptures that without faith, it's impossible to please him. Now, granted that God, no money will answer all things because you're dealing with the seizure income. But wait, well, watch and see when God get the heart of seizure. Oh boy, when he get the heart of seizure, then everything gonna be free. You understand what I'm saying? At a certain point, because now he got the heart of the king in his hands. Let me say that again. When God got the heart of the king in his hands, everything will start to change. Because now the king is going to want to please God. And see, God's telling you that we are more than conquerors. And so if there is a particular person that's in a position that rules like that, that's got the money, they don't have the God in their heart. But when God lay hold to them, he gonna have so much that he gonna want to say, you know, let everybody do everything free, because I'm rich enough that I serve God in spirit and in truth that I could pay for it all because of the God I serve. Because the God I serve, I believe he will give it to me fruitful, multiply, running it over. I ain't just talking about in God we trust, but I know that if I trust in God and I give it to the kingdom of God, and I really believe that God is who he is, I promise to give you when you come to me. He didn't say that I was going to give you 25% of what I promised to give you. He didn't promise to give you just 75%, but you give him 75% or 55% or 95% or 99.9%, but you want God to give you everything, which he will, but you gonna get it with persecutions and afflictions because you're not giving him everything. If you give God everything, he'll give you everything. That's the Father in who we serve. That's the Father of the universe. If you prove to him that, hey, I can do this the way that you say, and I can give you all so that you can give me all. It's not that mindset, but in a way it is that mindset. That if your God will supply all your needs, why not give him all? Because he about to give you all and some. That was the problem with the rich young ruler in the scriptures. He had an issue. He kept half of the commandments, and then at that, he wound up doing something that really was ridiculous. He could not sell everything when required. When the kings told him, look, go sell everything to the poor, then come into the kingdom. Because when you come into the kingdom, now everything that you need, you're going to receive. But he got discouraged because he didn't think the King of Kings had anything. Oh, but that was the big mistake right there. When the king, he was the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He, just because he didn't have what the rich young ruler had, the rich young ruler forgot who he was communicating with. He was communicating with the Lord of Lords and King of Kings. So if he was the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, or the Lord of Lords, the King of Kings, no matter how you want to twist it and put it out there, if he would have really humbled himself, he would have got a 100-fold return on everything that he would have sold to the poor. What am I saying to you? God is wanting you to give your whole heart to him without complaint. Don't give him 10% thinking that you're going to get a 100-fold return. God is not manipulated. You can't deceive him. God is not mocked. For whatsoever man soweth, that shall he also reap.